back, ladies and gentlemen, to RGN again here for another matchup. We've got a best of three this time around, Tempest versus Leisure, and the round of eight. So we'll see who's going to come out on top as our maps are going to be, well, Dust 2 to start, and that is the map choice of Leisure. We've got Cobblestone, and then potentially Mirage if we need a third. So again, right back into things. I'm joined by Laser Jesus. I am Sprawl, and Dust 2. Excited to see some Dust 2 early in. Well, I guess it's still my morning, but not necessarily yours if you're in the European region as Tempest. Look at the setup here. Very aggressive on a catwalk. They don't put anyone towards long A. And actually, you got Walter spotting long A just in case. We got Z1 towards middle spotting the double doors.
Really unfortunate timing for NSW. The moment he decides to take a peek towards the catwalk, that's when the T's from down below at floor B decide to peek out. However, it's going one for one. NSW from earlier, really low though. With the long scouting, it's already gotten them the bomb site, and nobody's watching the cross for Tempest, so this will be the bomb site for Leisure, and they should get the bomb down. And look at this lurk, way back in T-spawn from Light. So Tempest still have they gotta worry about this player.
Oh, Light. Rest in peace, Rami puts him away. As now, can focus more on the bomb site. Remux still towards long, and he does take down Rami very swiftly. Fenny now all alone, as he does take down Faker. And that will be the extent of his success. Two left up for Leisure, and they take T-Pistol.
Yeah, I remember Fenny, big name that stands out from the previous game we saw from Tempest. But just unfortunate setup for Tempest. Not like it's a bad setup at all. Just the timing of it, and then depending on what the T's elect to do, maybe if the T's want fast mid control, then that setup works out really well. Nice little shot on the cross. I think it was delivered from Remux. But yeah, if you have a slow play, and then if the T's work out long, and when you don't have anybody at long for the CT side, it could be really problematic with that mid stack. They almost got it done. It was a 4-on-4, but the 4-spy out from Tempest. Two players actually saving, though.
Yeah, interesting stuff as Leisure just spreading out across the map. Nothing too special here as Faker from lower tunnels watches towards the mid-double doors. It's the only thing that's not really covered. Well, Remux now on it as Catwalk was a vulnerable area, but nothing too crazy from Tempest on this force buy. You can see they're playing fairly passive towards the bomb sites. Rami actually heading towards middle now, and the opener towards the B-bomb site. Fenny in an awful spot. He does drop M&L very low, but I don't think that's going to be good enough here as Rami trying to find the long-distance shot with said Deagle. They're caught in CT spawn, and looks like Leisure might be able to survive this round without losing anybody, depending if the CTs just want to save these pistols into the next.
And it's a hard spot for the pistols, too, because you're not going to be buying in the next round, obviously, but do you want to take away some of the weapons of the T's? By doing so, you might just generate a lot more money for them if you run into the MAC-10. But Z1 has found himself an AK. Drops it at mid, peeks back out and just lets it rip. Rami's found another kill, though, on the light. But all these weapons should be just, you know, recovered if anybody of the T's are holding the lesser one. So even though Leisure do drop two, I think all they lost out of it was a scout and a MAC-10.
Yeah, so not too bad at all, mitigating that damage. And considering Tempest, how much they put into the round, not exactly what they were hoping to get out of it, that's for certain. As you can see, moving into this next one, you had those players that didn't purchase very much, the two, but everybody else, obviously, complete full save. As we see, just some P250s purchased. And I'd like to see something a little bit more creative now that they definitely don't have a chance playing anything default.
It's really neat from Leisure here. The rush out of long for the T side as Remux picks up too with the Tech 9. What are the chances of a nade stack from the CT side? After they just four spot with three of their players, there's no way a long nade stack is coming through, and I love that read from Leisure.
Yeah, it allows them free entry into that real estate. And then once you're out long, especially versus pistols, there's not as many close range angles that are going to catch you off guard. Maybe if you can play in an insane position inside of the pit, you can catch someone off, but it's going to be traded off more than likely. And yeah, once you get out long, it's that first area towards blue bin and the actual doors. It's pretty crummy, especially if you get nade stacked, as it'll be 3-0, surviving with 4 here as Leisure. And not a bad start to the map for them, as we will see Tempest on their first buy, Z1 going with that AWP.
Excellent anti-ecos by Leisure and the one anti-force buy. All they lost out of that was a couple pairs of armor, or three pairs of armor. Three armor sets, there we go, Chad. And Tech 9 Scout as well as a MAC 10. So not a lot lost for Leisure. And wow, look at this play. They're going bomb solo out into the B bomb site. And the rest of the players are cut off through a smoke. And now they got to run through some fire if they want it. Another smoke comes through. This is just not looking good for Leisure. They got split from that smoke. And that seemed to be like the round.
Yeah, Fenny's shutting the rest of this situation down. Light trying to salvage as he's just stuck inside of the smoke of that office. Not a fun feeling, as he can only exit one way. That being said, Remux does find a frag on the opposite end of the map. And on the 2-on-3, they at least have time in their hands. So maybe Leisure, if they slow this down and Remux can work towards middle potentially, or maybe he'll just go towards upper tunnels. But yeah, I like the middle play a little bit more. See how this pans out.
It's like that Quantum Break game, Chad. Time is power.
Right.
If you've seen that commercial yet. Z1 quite low. Okay, that makes Remux's chances fall quite a bit, but they want to fight him at mid. I don't know if they should be taking these fights very low. Now Fenny actually gets lit up a little bit. But Remux is going to make his way into the tunnels. I think Rami just got his way around into the T-spawn area. Remux likely to have heard this. Well, if Rami's not careful with his peek. Oh, there's another player? Okay, I got a little confused. But Remux won't be able to bring anybody else with him. And that's not what Leisure planned. Don't think that was the strat, to have a P90 rush solo into B.
Yeah, that was very, very messy. As, like you had stated, they just kind of got separated. And Fenny actually was very disciplined in that he was playing towards like the big box in a way that I thought he was just going to line them all up as they were hugging like the left side from his point of view. But whoa, hold that thought. We got Light hitting a nasty shot. Walter goes down in middle, and Tempest, that's not fun.
Fast pace from Leisure is now they take out long quickly. They tried B quickly last time. Man. Another one through the door with a headshot. This guy's cheating, Chad. You might even get another one. Rami, he's working his way slow on to catwalk. Oh, it was Faker this time. Light, either way, that's two for him. The ops out to play here for Leisure. Double op set up on the T side, doing all the damage. And Tempest left to save. I think Leisure has just enough to go for this. No, they don't have much left in the bank at all. So that's nice by NSW, but he knows that going for this is near sure suicide. So two guns for Tempest in the next, but a hard reset.
Yeah, not what you want to see after picking up your first gun round, that's for certain. And Leisure, if they can survive with four here, that immediately puts them back in a pretty decent economic situation. The double op as well, and if Light can hit any more shots like that, again, two through the doors, that was ridiculous. And then, yeah, Faker with one on the catwalk. The op's out to play at the moment. It looks like they should be able to keep these weapons alive on that CT front. NSW might have Remux coming close. Now they'll try and pinch towards the B-bomb site. And again, those weapons will make it on through. So, Leisure. This is definitely what they were hoping for. As again, this is, I believe, their map choice. Yeah, it is their map choice. Tempest opting to start on that CT side. So, great T side start. And you can see with that four player left alive in that last round, get a decent amount of money out of it. We'll see. Oh, Rami. There we go. So, again, he's going to find a tag on the cross. Rami takes a little bit. And very quick pressure towards B from Leisure. And I think this time it's going to pan out better, Laser.
Yeah, no smokes up this time. Too bad for Rami. It was very late that he decided to invest into the vest. But then he gets tagged on the cross and then naded. So just a 1K down the drain for absolutely nothing. No fault of his own, though.
Yeah, exactly. It's difficult. You can only really just try and juke them out so much on that door cross, right? And then, again, there's only so much you can do. So hitting the shot right now.
I don't like Tempest fighting for weapons at all. They need these two weapons. Two players are at 1,500. If they're planning to buy, they need both of these.
And, well, the downside, of course, is that Leisure surviving with four yet again, but they definitely need to think about their own economy first and foremost, but Leisure's going to be a good spot. M&L not able to find NSW as he tried to flash his way out of the tunnels. And looks like, all right, so surviving with three. Fenny actually hears a player towards long aim, coming up from behind him and takes him down as well. So good news, Leisure only going to survive with two, but still, to be fair, got a good bank growing as Tempest still with only that one round. And yeah, like you can see now, very important, like you had stated, that they keep those weapons as now the full buy comes in.
And nicely done by Tempest. Risky, but nicely done. I mean, they couldn't have put Leisure's economy at a point where they'd have to save upon losing, so I thought it was a little too risky. However, they do it safely enough. What's up?
Just Fenny getting hit on the cross.
Is that 100% since the ops came out?
I think it must. I don't think that there was... Yeah, no, it definitely is. I'm trying to think of that first... Or the fourth round when the CTs took their first... I don't think that there was anything on that round. But everything since then has just been dominating from Leisure and those op presence.
So mid control for Leisure. Still fighting for it as NSW, but the entry from Remux. And that forces Rami, NSW's teammate, to fall off along and join his teammate on the catwalk. But they really don't have control of anything. They got Z1 on top of the catwalk, the op and drop angle. But that's not necessarily control of the catwalk if you don't have a teammate there with you. But everybody creeping into the B-bomb site. Fenny's playing an angle where he's going to have no idea the T's are here until there's multiple. But the angle has been checked. And Fenny's fate decided. And light towards the A-bomb site. This is just not going well for Tempest at all.
Yeah, Leisure with more than enough resources to take B and then still have someone poking towards long A. And it doesn't look like the CTs will survive with anything here. We got Z1 playing towards CT spawn and yeah, not able to find Uni as Leisure just, again, looking very dominant in that round, surviving with four. That's just, again, fantastic for them as I'll build that buffer that we weren't able to see in, like, say, for example, the last best of one. We had some dominant score lines early in halves, but that score line, or sorry, the financials never really reflected it. Leisure, though, with that benefit, and they've even got another round where Tempest is very minimal to work with, so another opportunity to further that advantage as we see a couple up towards the catwalk area. Rami does find light. Can't secure that AWP, but it will cue the further the aggression from the catwalk. But I don't know how much more they'll get out of it. Z1 is crouching at the steps all alone.
A little miscoordination at the beginning for Leisure. They wanted to run out mid-flash fast, but it ended up hot-flashing light instead as another frag claimed by Z1. Gotten himself an op, too. Leisure, yeah, they got a bit of a bank, but that could be destroyed, maybe even losing the round. That's Z1 with another one, and he has an idea that a player is right below him. Oh, no. The T. Oh, he knows he's there, too, though. M&L. He's going to fall off of it.
Oh, man.
You got to do it, Chad.
Right. Just goes for it. I don't think he recognized, but M&L, you can see, is on 9 hit points. That was from a flick. The first shot that he took with that op was towards that player in CT spawn and hit him through the ledge on Cat there. So if that was actually a frag, again, a different situation as he took down the player at Xbox, but probably would have changed how the Xbox player plays a little bit. But nonetheless, close situation. We'll see Leisure hold on. As maybe that's the fire they needed, though, is... See the spamming towards the mid double doors and no connection this time around. And just finally with a situation where they can have an actual 5-on-5 full hit points on everyone.
They, being the Tempest, dropped a nade for the cross this time, so make sure nobody takes any damage, but Remux again towards long, forcing the other CT that was playing long of an NSW to fall back. So now, another 5-on-4. That Tempest, they just can't seem to avoid these situations, and Light furthering that advantage. As he'll continue to be a nuisance at long, Tempest are trying to boost back into the bomb site, but there's a Remux. He's making his way swiftly up the catwalk, and there's the flank. Light, in the meantime, picks up another. Leisure feeling mighty confident. They're just going to drop down into the CT spawn, and Remux makes it look easy. Yeah, I think it's time for a timeout, Chad.
Yeah, I would have to agree with this, Walter, calling for that, and I'm trying to think of
maybe
what
even
the adjustment...
exclamation point problem.
Right, yeah, they definitely have a problem, that is for certain, as Their problem is they are getting smashed at the moment. And yeah, what's the adjustment if you're Tempest? And that I feel like Leisure hasn't necessarily just stuck to one specific strat that's won them the round. In that, well, in that it's been, it hasn't been just like a set execute that it's like, okay, XYZ, this is how we cover these spots a little better. Leisure has been able to find openings, and then they almost just sit on it, allow Tempest to squirm in a way that, again, Light's been finding these picks towards middle after they found a frag already, and Tempest trying to adjust on the fly and almost giving up picks accordingly. In Light, my god, this man's not done.
This, how do you do that consistently? It's always been one of my problems, you know, when I was playing as an opera. All the other top tier operas were so good at hitting that cross shot, and Light doing that like even better and finding headshots constantly, always getting some damage whenever there's not a nade up on the cross. Really hard thing to be consistent at. It's, I think, even more so in Go than other iterations of the game. But yeah, what's the adjustment from Tempest? I think it's, you know, don't get entry. Leisure, at the beginning of the rounds, is coming at him that in-your-face style and forcing duels at long right away. The Leisure seems to come out on top of. If Tempest can maybe get that frag and then you know, have themselves fall off, then those two ops are going to be forced to take more dangerous duels, because Leisure's running that double op setup constantly. So if you have one AK and two ops, then it's much harder to work your way back into the round if you don't have any map control. So Tempest, they just can't get entried at the beginning of the round, because yeah, that's the problem. Once they go down numbers, Leisure just furthers that by big margins.
9-1, Tempest. See if they can start building that comeback, as they've definitely made it difficult for themselves in that, well, now Leisure, they have a luxurious bank account. Light's going to take down Z1 towards long. NSW fires back, and this is first time in a while we're going to see advantage to the CTs, but they need to deny catwalk, and it's not going to be so, as Rami does fall. So yeah, they've got long control with NSW, but a bomb site is open for business as the plant goes down towards Cat, and Walter falls as well. And it's not looking good.
Yeah, this is just a dominant display from Leisure, and at the feet. Surprised, right? He's got any left. Probably like a half of one. He's crawling.
Yeah.
He's one for one again. NSW, this would be a nice pickup for Tempest. Give him a no. Wow.
NSW, that was probably the sickest spray control I've seen in a long, long time. Okay, NSW with the ace, and he's like, I don't know if my team's gonna show up in this half at all, but I'm certainly going to, as, comes up with the ace and gives Tempest a shot here.
That was some godlike spray control. How do you do that? And even realizing the moment you get the headshot to shift over that fast into another instant headshot, you know, you can't call it all skill, I guess, or maybe you can. Maybe it's just control is that amazing, but shifting while controlling your spray to that degree. But he did it consecutively, so can't doubt the guy. But I think a lot of that round came down to the over-aggression at long from Leisure. They got the entry pick, and then they didn't expect NSW to be already crossed towards the pit, and that got him two kills as nobody had their gun out ready to blast him. And then it resulted in him having an amazing play and an amazing ace and towards the catwalk. But Tempest still have not been able to solve the problem, which is we can't stop them at long. They come out long every round, and we can't stop them even when we have three people there.
Yeah, Z1's going to be playing very passive towards the A platform, and if you're going to try and contest Light, Light spots him hopping over the smoke. Z1 getting a little confident there, and at least that he wants to find out how many players are coming on up, and he's boosted on top of the boxes. They're going to be playing that close angle, though, and they actually Molotov out Z1's spot here. He finds a little cubby, but I don't think it's going to be enough as they blindside. Well, they don't blindside him. He gets one shot off, and he's looking their direction, but he's just completely dealt with. It's now a 3-on-5, and Tempest, they can't lose this round and be reset again.
Yeah, I guess you got to go for it. You can't lose this round. You said it. They need it desperately. And this would mean GG in my eyes. And they're going to fall off as Fenny grabs a kill. So a hard reset. What do you do in this round? This is the problem. By not going for it, you have two weapons. One round loss bonus. 1,600 on one guy, 1K on the other. What? That's a Famas on one, like a Mag 7 or a Scout on another in a round. that even if you save again thereafter, the chances of you saving these weapons from, you know, Walter and Rami in the next round are pretty slim too. So just problems compiling for Tempest. So what do you do here?
Oh, Walter falls as well. M&L with the buzzer beater, so to speak. It just gets him right as the round switches to the next, and only one weapon now. That's super unfortunate for Tempest as well. It's kind of been the story of this half. Just super unfortunate. Double digits for Leisure.
Let's get a nade stack strong, man. And they go long every round.
Yeah, at least they're coming up with, yeah, no nade stack. But it looked like they were trying a flash play. Man, that did not pan out anywhere near what I was hoping for the Tempest side. I was hoping maybe little fires lit underneath them as they were trying to take long together. But yeah, maybe if they start that with an aid stack, it comes up with different results as they're kind of peppered before they come through. But 11 now for the Leisure side.
And every time at long, it's not even like it's a leisurely take. It's fast right away. And the Leisure is rushing out long. And Tempest should know this at this point. But however, with this massive B spawn, maybe Leisure decides to switch it up and go for the B rush, because you know Tempest is going to be playing 3 towards A. So, nice read. And it's almost an easy read, like a forced read.
So, here we go. B bomb site play for Leisure as they're just like, well, let's give this a try. Made one round. It didn't pan out, but this one certainly looking like it will. Z1 close to the double doors towards B, but he smoked off. And he just runs through the smoke. Actually does drop a player, but Tempest looking a little disjointed as, oh, if it didn't work once, try it again. Walter's going to do the exact same thing. As Rami now left all alone. Well, he falls as well. Just incredible T-side play from Leisure, in that they've completely taken Tempest out of this map.
It's hard to call it incredible. I think it's more Tempest faltering, but you can't take anything away from Leisure. And one of the rounds from Tempest came out from an extraordinary play from NSW. Other than that, Leisure, they take out long every single round. Tempest, you know, they play long often, but they just can't stop the initial take out from Leisure. And here it is again. Fast play out long. Only two people here from Tempest this time, and I think we're going to see similar results. Leisure just taking full control.
Now Walter trying to put up some sort of defense, but he falls. Z1 on the jump shot. He's going to try and prevent the cross, but I don't like his chances as he's burning a little bit. Actually, like, jumps into fire, like his headlights on fire. Yeah, that's not fun. Fenny shows up on the platform, spamming away, and actually does come up with two. Now it's NSW, has to come up big, and he's going to find an AK in his adventures as makes his way up from long A. And I don't know if I think he spotted Remux jumping there, so he's got quite a bit of intel.
So he gets a freebie. Where's the next? Faker now knows it's a straight 1v1 in the...
Wow.
Nice shot from Faker. Not this time. Don't give him a chance to spray. And what a weird half. Leisure just take long whenever they want it, and Tempest couldn't stop it. And then Leisure, you know, Tempest is going to play 3 long considering what Leisure's been doing every round. So one of the rounds are like, okay, let's go towards B maximum. We see two people here, maybe one there, one rotate.
Yeah, 13-2. I just did not expect this to pan out this way. I expected a little bit more from the Tempest side, but well, we'll see if maybe they can do anything here on their T front. Pistol obviously is their only chance to get anything going. If they lose that, won't see rifles necessarily. We'll see. As M13-2, Tempest with a lot of utility moving into this round.
Sorry, Chad, missed my cue. I'm back. No problem. Let's see, Tempest. They want their revenge at long, though. They wait out the early nade. And then they're going to bust out. But can Leisure hold it as well as they can take it? So far, no. Light and Uni, though, they're back at the A-bomb site. How fast are Temp? They have a lot of utility to make this work. I mean, there's still a bunch of flashbangs ready. The smokes are going to be up. How much are they going to have left for the... Oh, wow, Leisure! They try to rush out of the smoke. And, yeah, there's too many T's.
That was very interesting, as I thought that Leisure did something cool and that Uni actually chest bumped the cross smoke, so there's a gap in it. So I was like, If you do that and you create a gap for yourself, why not use it? A Tempest just going to swarm into the bomb site and they're just going to take the round. But
the call was made, Chad.
Right?
We're going.
Like, Uni's like, but I just blocked that, so now, and they're like, run through the smoke. And it's like, okay, all right, well, here we go, boys.
They listen. At least Leisure listens to the calls, man. Right? They fought. They go together, like the Mighty Ducks or something. I don't know if the reference holds as much weight over there, but anyways, Tempest now going fast into B. And we do have a buy from Leisure. Remux only gets one, but now it's Faker's turn to rotate, and the flank is already on its way. Faker getting one, but the flank, they don't realize there's somebody still in the T spawn, but NSW, mark, what's going on for Tempest? This round loss means the match.
Not like this, Light and Uni. Left at a 2-on-2, Rami and Fenny. They bait planted once, but Light finds the quick shot onto Rami, and now it's a 1-on-1. Uni can't find it. It's Fenny to salvage the situation, but Tempest. Whew, betted on a B-side play. It wasn't even Leisure with, like, if you're going to put 5-7s in the B-bomb site, there's probably some closer angles that might be even more powerful. Leisure actually played fairly far back and still got a lot of work done. So, yeah, great work from them on the pistols.
Yeah, it almost worked. NSW should have shut the round down when he had them both lined up in the T-spawn. But, hey, the AK got away from him. And both teams going real fast on their anti-ecos, it seems. Maybe it'll transfer to the gun round. What's up with Light?
Oh, no. He was playing the fire angle at Carr, where you're, like, just hoping they don't realize that you're behind the fire. I don't even think there's even really fire there anymore, is there? Yeah, you can't
it's
even...
It's been dwindled a lot. I know that.
Yeah, my graphics are set really low, so it doesn't even show up at all for me. But I think it is a little bit there, still enough that you can get it. I think Kerrigan was the one that made it kind of famous, and then I saw him after they fixed it. He still did it, and it still worked. But anyhow, I think maybe since then even more fixes, but it doesn't work out there for the Leisure side. So Tempest, they take those first three that are obviously required, but still, you got to figure Leisure. There's no room for mistakes on that Tempest side.
None at all. They don't have a bank. They need this one. They need the rest of them. They got to keep Leisure low. And they, hopefully for them, whenever Leisure does win a round, Tempest will be able to reset. A lot of things need to go right. Tempest, yep, they want their revenge at long. Both teams seem to think each other's long is weak, or they both just have very strong long takes. But the classic, you get the players into pit, you fall off and either split onto A or turn it into a mid to B, or just bring it everybody back towards long. But Light's here with the op, and he's been dropping people.
So Tempest about to cross long. Light is playing at that close box, but he dealt with, wow, immediately. It's going to be Tempest taking multiple frags. NSW with a double kill. Now it's Faker and Remux to try and find some sort of retake, but this is going to be another round building to the comeback. Walter lets his position be known towards that close long A angle. Remux going to flash his way out. Walter able to, I think he avoided it, just to get his grasp back towards that player, and Faker falls after Remux goes down to Z1. So Tempest now six rounds on their scoreboard, and well, they're building up a bit of economy as well. But of course, if you're going to pick when you would lose a round, of course, again, I always kind of highlight this. You would never actually want to lose a round, but if you were to pick, you definitely want it way later. And then you reset Leisure again, and they're on 14, and you're kind of close to pushing it over the edge for yourself. That's the optimal spot is. We'll see Faker get opt on the cross, and maybe that'll cue Tempest another B-side play.
And both teams just love to rush on their anti-ecos, just switching it up. They're rushing long, we're rushing B. Choose one, that's where we're coming, but back at him. Two frags from Leisure. And Tempest really need to maintain this bank, because if they are the ones that get reset, or even have to come up with a shoddy buy whenever Leisure get their weapons out, that'll be pretty big problems. There's Leisure making a bunch of noise outside of the tunnels, maybe trying to fake for their tunnels player. But they can try to strip away weapons off of this. I mean, we just announced that two players were outside of the B tunnels, so our B the double doors. So Uni, he's gonna make his way back into the tunnels, and I like that play. Just minor difference.
And he will get an AK out of it, so good news in that regard. And light still covering the double door's side towards mid, and well, Fanny does deal with them, so they will escape. But Leisure netting themselves at least that one AK from the round. Uni should be happy about that. But yeah, Tempest, they've built up, again, quite the economy here. As got 11K or so. Or actually, that was pre-buy on NSW. Back down to 8, but still looking all right. Leisure. We'll see if they can finally find something here as we got light on that AWP. It was hot in the last half. I think he went down without a frag in the last round that he picked it up. We'll see as they put two off towards B early. They're looking for long control on the CT side as we see an incendiary going down.
Is this a default? What is this?
Right. And he's going to head towards doors, but T's working slow as well.
And we haven't seen a default in quite some time. And finally, teams will stop going for the rush. So catwalk soon enough for Tempest. Light is at the op and drop. Oh. And he peeks out swiftly. He wasn't even peeking it right away. Just goes for the repeat after the flashes were thrown. And this is a strong round from Leisure. Completely shut down catwalk and long. What's left for the options of Tempest? Well, I guess you try to go back up catwalk or go for a mid to B. But Leisure, they're not done with the aggression. They got Remux coming up lower B, and Leisure with all the intel in the world.
Yeah, that was such a sick setup from Leisure in that Tempest almost played into it after they chased the op. As they had a player from A-Ramp able to take him down as he was vulnerable, peeking out on Cat. And after that, they queued the upper tunnel push, Leisure just gaining even more control. And it's pretty cool when you actually see that take effect in that there's always kind of a right time to make that aggressive call, even if you're up a player. You can specifically on Dust, when you think that you've got the read that they are towards Cat, that almost guarantees it. Yeah, it could backfire, but if you have an advantage, you might be able to still be able to work with the information. It is definitely a risk, but one that's definitely sometimes worth taking, as we see so much intel gained off of it as Leisure look to go head-to-head towards long A here. And, well, it looks like it's going the way of the T's, but Light, two frags for him, and he finds the close one onto Rami,
wow,
follows it up on a Fenny, Walter all alone, scratching his head, wondering what happened to that long take. Leisure, that's the control we thought they might establish.
Why haven't I saw this guy before?
Light, doing big things.
I think it's my first time seeing him. I could be wrong, but I feel like, you know, like Mertz, like I would have remembered somebody going off with the op like this, which I'm so fond of. And seeing plays like that, you might be seeing this guy again, or who knows, he might be cheating. We'll find out soon enough. His Leisure got to deal with the B-bomb site play incoming from Tempest. This is going to be it. This is Tempest's last chance. They're going to try to bust in, but Remux, he's playing close, and I think he's just about to chop off a bunch of shins, Chad.
Yeah, this is definitely a hard counter to this kind of play would be that close player. Unless they can flash out in a way that blinds him. Oh, he's going to play an anti-flash, just facing the wall as well, because he's got so many teammates to help him out. They go with the forward smoke here, and he should be able to just line them up. And indeed, that is the case as they all fall down. Rami all alone. And he will be able to take down one, but that will be the extent of it. So, yeah, that was a massive map from Lights on 16 frags at the end, but I don't think that proves how impactful he was with that AWP. And we did see them versus Team Singularity. I believe that was the last map, or the last match that we saw. Oh, no, sorry, that was with Tempest. No, have we seen one with Leisure? I thought that we saw Leisure earlier. Yeah, it was versus
seen them in previous
Isuba.
Tournaments.
You know, I think we saw them against Isuba as well. I don't think we had it on Lounge, but it was one of the kind of, one of the quieter days that we had, but I believe we did broadcast that was 19-17 on Cobble and then 16-4 on Cash. Yeah, because they were playing against they were playing with Vladirox at that point. I do remember that. And there was Henki, Monty, Ben Q. We had made some jokes about him on the other side. Anyhow,